Hello, so here's a quick tip to the dimension tool in Illustrator. Now, maybe you've already seen it. There's been an update to the Illustrator Beta that has the dimension tool in it. And if you haven't installed it, so here's how to install the Illustrator Beta. You go to the Creative Cloud app and into the Beta app section. And there you find the available Illustrator Betas. So let's close that. And let's take a look at this artwork in here. So I've got an ellipse, a circle, and here's another circle that I have opened. Then we have a rounded rectangle, and here are two lines. And I'm going to duplicate this, and let's just expand this shape. So let's go to Shape, Expand Shape, and this is now just a path, and this one is still an ellipse. And also I'm going to make another copy and make this into an ellipse, so it's not a circle. And now let's take a look at these. So the dimension tool is this in here. It's also available in the reduce toolbar. So if you have just the basic toolbar, then you have the dimension tool here. But I'm going to the advanced toolbar. And then when you select the dimension tool, then you get this head-up display. And that's the same as in the free transform tool. So you see, this is the free transform tool. They have gone the same route with the dimension tool. And then we have these options for the tool in here. And also in here, there's the tool options, what you can create with it. And you see we have different line types here. And also we have a new precision setting, like 3-digit after the comma, 3 decimal digits. And then let's cancel that when no artwork is selected and you have the tool, then you can also set up the tool options in the properties panel. So let's take a look at how to use it. You already know this one, and if you don't, I've got a video about it. I'm going to link it in the description. And new is this one in here, and with that you can measure the angle. Now here we've got those lines, and when you use this, click here and click here, and then drag where you want the dimension to go, and then we have the angle of this. So that's about it for the angle. Let's get to the radial dimension tool. And with that, you can click on the path, and you already see it measures the radius. And then you can click and drag, and you see when you drag in here, then you get the diameter, and when you drag out of it, then you get the radius. And you can also then move it up here, and you see then you can set where you want the measurement to go. And let's click again like this, then you get the diameter. This also works with this circle here, and you see we've got the diameter, and it doesn't work with the ellipse. You see, no measurement for the ellipse, but it works for this path, like so, and then we've got the radius here. And it also works for this rounded rectangle. And you see in here we've got this. I'm going to undo that. So let's drag out of here, and we've got the radius of these rounded rectangle. So like so, and like so, and like so. But if we open the settings like up here, then you see there we have decimal values. So let's take a look at those. And I'm going to select one of these. And then let's go to the precision in here and set the precision to something like this and apply this. And then we have also quick actions. And in there we can apply this to all on the canvas, and you see we get just more precise measurements.